to know for November 21, coming to you from Meadow Mill. I'm Amanda, and this is Alan. You can join us here every Tuesday at 12:30 for your weekly news roundup and a discussion of current events. Please feel free to comment and ask us questions in the field below. Alan, we're going to have to get into the latest sexual abuse allegations a little later. But first, did you happen to watch Baltimore Rising last night on HBO?
No, I did not.
I did not either. I meant to, but then I ended up running around all over the house and forgot that I was supposed to be watching that. Mm-hmm. So I missed it. But I mean, we all can still watch it. But go ahead and tell us a little bit about what it is.
Okay. Well, it's Sonia Sohn's new documentary. It's about the unrest in Baltimore brought on by the death of Freddie Gray in 2015 while in police custody. It debuted Monday night on HBO. Sohn is best known for her role as Kima Greggs on The Wire. She accumulated 600 hours of footage in order to make the 90-minute film.
Wow.
It follows activists, police officers, community leaders, and gang members during the unrest. And it sounds like it was pretty powerful stuff.
Yeah. Let us know if you watched it and what you thought about it. I know that Sohn has been very active in and supportive of Baltimore for decades, so I think she would be the one to get it right, mm-hmm. as opposed to several of the news outlets who were in town during the event. So do you have to hit the road when you go to get your Thanksgiving meal?
No, this year I'm going to be at home, actually.
I'm very happy about it. Glenn,
yes,
you don't have to hit the road
fortunate.
Either. Nope. None of us has to actually hit the road, which is really good news because it's supposed to be horrendous this year.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Tell us.
I know Stan Charles is actually going to New York, so
a lot of people have to, and I hope they left or are about to leave.
Well, what is expected to be a record-breaking Thanksgiving travel weekend, the Maryland Department of Transportation has issued some travel tips that might help to make the entire experience a little bit more manageable. They suggest traveling at off-peak hours if you can.
Sure.
Today and tomorrow, try to leave before 6 a.m. and after 11 p.m. And on Thursday through Sunday, the best travel times are before 9 a.m. and after 9 p.m. For more travel tips, go to m.maryland.gov.
And I know that if you're flying, you need to get to the airport 2 hours before your departed flight.
Yes.
Departure time.
Right. So switching gears a bit, Charles Manson, one of the most notorious murderers, that is a real switch, isn't it?
That's a big switch.
Yeah. One of the most notorious murderers of the 20th century died of natural causes on Sunday in Kern County, California. Mm. He was 83 and had been behind bars for most of his life. According to obituary in the New York Times. Convicted of 9 murders in all, Manson was known in particular for the 7 brutal killings collectively called the Tate-LaBianca murders, committed by his followers on 2 consecutive nights in August of 1969. The most famous of his victims was actress Sharon Tate, who was pregnant at the time and married to the film director Roman Polanski.
And why do you care, you may ask? Maybe because he tried to incite race riots with those murders and his weird logic. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he had a swastika carved into his forehead.
Yeah.
That too. So those of you who didn't read the New York Times obituary, you should really check it out. They did an amazing job. It's like everything that an obituary should be. Read it. Also, Alan, I heard somewhere, not in that obituary, but somewhere else, that Manson was only 5'2".
Yeah.
I never knew this.
Yeah, he was a diminutive guy, wasn't he?
He was tiny.
Yeah.
Which
well,
is, it's so
the swastika
odd.
made him look taller, you know?
It's a swastika add 2 inches to my eye. Well, anyway, yeah.
But don't try it at home.
No, don't carve a swastika or anything else into your forehead. But, yeah, I just never knew that.
Yeah.
And it's fascinating.
Well, you knew he was little, right?
I never even thought about it. Hmm. I didn't know. He was tiny.
Right. But you didn't know he was that tiny.
I did not know. Okay. I mean, that's very small. That's smaller than me.
Wow.
He would not be able to reach this microphone to do this radio show.
He'd need a telephone book, too.
All right, so if you're just joining us, this is Jay Moore's Need to Know on Facebook Live. Ask us whatever you like in the comments below. Tell us what you thought of Baltimore Rising. Like, comment, and share at hashtag Jay Moore Need to Know. Okay, so now we do need to get back to this whole sexual misconduct.
Yes, Jeffrey Tambor.
Yeah.
The actor said he will not return for the 5th season of the Emmy Award-winning TV comedy Transparent, following a second accusation of sexual harassment made by a female member of the show's cast. Quote, playing Mara Pfefferman on Transparent has been one of the greatest privileges and creative experiences of my life, he told Deadline on Sunday. This is no longer the job I signed up for 4 years ago. I've already made clear my deep regret if any action of mine was ever misinterpreted by anyone as being aggressive, but the idea that I would deliberately harass is simply and utterly untrue. Given the politicized atmosphere that seems to have afflicted our set, I don't see how I can return to Transparent. Deadline reported that the writers of Transparent were contemplating writing Tambor out of the 5th season of this Amazon series.
Okay.
And then there's Al Franken. A second woman has come forward to accuse the senator. Lindsay Menz, 33, said that Franken grabbed her buttocks when they took a photo together at the Minnesota State Fair in 2010. Menz called the incident an uncomfortable interaction, I guess so,
yeah, I think
that
so.
Left her feeling, quote, gross. Mm-hmm. She told CNN that as her husband snapped a photo of her and Franken, he pulled her in, quote, awkward clothes and put his hand full-fledged on my rear. In a statement Monday on CNN, Franken said he didn't remember taking the photo with Menz, but that he felt badly that Ms. Menz came away from our interaction feeling disrespected. The photo shows the two of them standing close together, both smiling.
Okay, and now?
Glenn Thrush. The New York Times suspended its Washington, D.C. correspondent amid allegations that he made unwarranted advances toward female journalists. The Times said Monday that it was looking into the allegations made by four women. The allegations were published Monday in a Vox article. The women making the allegations include Laura McGann, author of the Vox article, as well as three unnamed women. Three of the incidents took place while Thrush was working at Politico, while one was during Thrush's tenure at the Times, according to the allegations. McGann wrote that the other women, all in their 20s, had similar experiences, quote, from unwanted groping and kissing to wet kisses out of nowhere to hazy sexual encounters that played out under the influence of alcohol. In a statement, Thrush claimed that his encounter with McGann was consensual but apologized for an incident with one of the unnamed women. Quote, The woman involved, I was upset by my actions, and for that I'm deeply sorry. Thrush said he had been struggling in recent years with alcoholism in response to personal and health crises.
Okay, Alan, so I want to talk about this a little bit.
Okay.
Those were all incidents of Jews behaving badly. But we also had TV host Charlie Rose this week.
Yep.
He's not Jewish.
No.
He was accused by eight women who said he made unwanted sexual advances toward them, including lewd phone calls, walking around naked in their presence.
Yeah.
And and now they've taken that show off there. I don't understand how all these people have time to be naked so often that it's in people's faces, in their coworkers' faces. But anyway, so that show's been currently taken off the air. So this is the question I want to raise. Does it help matters to erase these figures from our collective cultural consciousness? Is it exactly the same as removing the Confederate statues? We just took those away. No comment, no historical reference, no whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Can the art or media stand on its own and continue to exist despite a person's crimes?
Right.
I'm curious because we're writing whole characters out of shows. There's a lot of dead characters right now. We're going to kill off probably Kevin Spacey, probably Jeffrey Tambor.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have stuff in history like Alfred Hitchcock, who Tippi Hedren has been very vocal about. Everyone's been very vocal about him. I mean, there's a whole movie about him.
Rather lecherous.
Yes, and his movies are classics.
Right.
He was probably an artistic genius.
Right.
Can't we still watch those movies? Can we separate the two?
Well, I think we're going to have to because, you know, these are great pieces of art made by people who were very, very flawed vessels. And I think there's just no way around that. And probably that's been from the beginning of time. But we're going to have to get used to that as this thing continues to spiral. A lot of our heroes are being knocked off their perches.
Exactly.
And we have to look at these works of art or these pieces of art with a different lens, I guess.
Right. I mean,
even though I know it's going to affect us, like when we watch Cosby, we're going to.
I haven't watched any Cosby since.
You can't help but think about it when you're watching it.
Right. And that's the thing. I have actually changed the way I've been watching current movies and TV shows. You know, even when I was watching Strange Things, which I love, it's a whole cast of kids. And I'm like, oh, were they okay? Are they going to be okay? You know.
You mean because of sexual abuse?
Well, I don't think there's any allegations in there, but I mean,
right.
I see a group of kids, and I wonder if they're going to make it out okay, alive, in one piece.
In Hollywood.
Because nobody seems to be doing that right now.
Right.
But, you know, like you mentioned earlier, are we just going to stop? We're never going to watch Tootsie again because Dustin Hoffman has allegations against him.
Or like we were talking about Manhattan.
Right, Manhattan is a classic. I think it's part of the Criterion Collection. We can't just wipe it off the face of the earth and remove it from the Criterion Collection, but it's pretty creepy, right?
That one's particularly creepy. Maybe another Woody Allen movie might be better.
Right, but I love Woody Allen movies. I think I go to all of them.
Manhattan's a great movie.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's just a question. I'm curious what you guys think out there. I want to know, like, can we still watch stuff? Can we listen to certain musicians?
That's a great question.
Can we just sort of maybe assume that everyone's a bit flawed, or most people are somewhat flawed, and it should maybe not affect the art and media that they produce.
There are going to be times that's going to be hard to do.
It is hard. And I do think that the politician thing should be separate. Mm-hmm. I think they represent their community, and they should be held to an ethical standard.
Well, they're working
and
for
they
us.
And they should be punished. I don't know if it's the same case to remove people from the shows that they're on. But
well, you know, Dustin Hoffman's always going to be a great actor no matter what. Who knows, he might have done the things that this woman is claiming, and he might be a sleazy individual. Who knows? But nothing can take away from The Graduate, Midnight Cowboy, etc. He's right. Always going to be known as a great actor.
Right. And like Elie Wiesel.
Mm-hmm. Elie Wiesel, of course.
Elie Wiesel.
Great author and humanitarian who maybe did something or didn't do something in 1989 that was inappropriate with a woman for a second. We're getting into a very tricky territory where we're equating certain kinds of sexual harassment with sexual abuse, and it gets very hazy.
It's murky.
Right, and obviously you don't want to justify or condone certain kinds of behavior. But one thing is, you know, inappropriate, and another thing is unlawful,
right.
Illegal. And
right, it's a crime.
Right.
Okay, so we're putting that out there in the universe. You tell us what you think, how you feel about all this, because I don't know, I'm kind of confused. Let's move on to the less serious items.
Yes, Barbara Streisand.
Yay!
Barbara Joan. Streisand, who is known for her severe stage fright, filmed a 2016 Miami concert for Netflix. It's called Barbara, the Music, the Memories, the Magic.
Mm.
A lot of ellipses. And it will be released on Wednesday. In the Netflix special, Streisand sings many of her best-known songs from her 11 number one albums.
Whoa,
wow.
That's a lot.
Yes, including...
You don't send me flowers anymore, Alan.
Right? People. People who need people.
Sorry.
Mixed with film clips and behind-the-camera footage from movies such as Yentl.
Papa, can you hear me?
And some of her recording sessions.
All right, so watch that. Who's watching? Raise your hand if you're going to watch. We know someone.
Me.
We do know someone.
Maybe Glenn. Maybe Glenn.
Glenn's got it recorded.
He's a closet Streisand fan.
That's weird. Let's not accuse Glenn of such things. All right, then one more ridiculous story holiday season.
Starbucks.
Oh, boy.
Starbucks just can't get a break when it comes to its holiday-themed cups. In 2015, conservative media and then presidential candidate Donald J. Trump accused Starbucks of engaging in a, quote, war on Christmas because of the cup's minimalist design. This year, the coffee giant changed things up a bit by featuring holiday symbolism on the cups, but it still couldn't avoid the confusion, according to Fortune.com. A promotional video for the holiday cups, which were unveiled on November 1st, shows two women looking at each other with hands clasped over a warm drink. The relationship between the women is unclear. Last week, a BuzzFeed article speculated on whether a cup was, quote, totally gay. Kind of
it's a cup.
Middle school.
It's a totally gay cup.
Because of the women in the promotional video. The cup also features a pair of disembodied hands. That's disturbing. That may or may not be of a sexual same-sex couple. Fox News responded to the BuzzFeed story and explained the controversy to its viewers. This year's Starbucks holiday theme is, quote, the holidays mean something different to everyone, as stated in the video. Obviously.
It's a cup, people.
Yeah, it's just a cup.
If I was in charge at Starbucks, I would just do something that would totally make everyone really mad.
Sure you would.
I would go like an all black cup, and I would just be like, happy holidays. Period.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Something really just dark.
That would still upset the conservative media.
Or Merry, yeah, because you can't say Merry Christmas. I mean, yeah, who knows? Who knows what you can say? I don't
know.
All right, we're ready for a totally topical holiday appropriate J word of the day.
Yes, a very appropriate for the holiday, and the word is Essen.
Essen.
It's Yiddish, and what does it mean? Eat. Usage, go ahead, Essen. Gesunde hate. We can always talk later.
I'm going to Essen like crazy on Thursday.
Yeah, I think we all are.
Going to Essen down, Glenn.
Hell yeah.
That's going to be it for us today. Remember to join us here Tuesdays at 12:30 for your Need to Know News Roundup. Don't forget to comment, join our discussion, like, share, and follow at hashtag JMoreNeedToKnow. Go to JMoreLiving.com for more news updates. Safe travels. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And Essen to your heart's
Essen.
Desire.
Gesunde hate.